Judith Collins' 105th day as national leader. It must feel about 10 times that in 10 days since the party's devastating election defeat. How do you rebuild after such a landslide defeat? What happens next for national Judith Collins? Mordena, welcome. Gosh, you look like you've had some sleep after
that. It's been a great weekend.
Yeah.
It was lovely weather and, you know, it's so nice to be able to actually have a few days in a row without having early starts and being able to get to sleep at a reasonable hour.
I saw you about 2 or 3 days. In fact, you're talking to Jenny May on breakfast. About 2 or 3 days beforehand, and you knew you were heading towards a disaster, didn't you? But you kept having to pretend otherwise.
Well, you just have to keep going, and you never know.
Yeah, but your own polling was brutal, wasn't it? But you had to go out and behave like somebody who could still win this thing. And what's the toll of that?
Well, I just pick yourself up every day, and you have to get out. And of course, there is always a personal toll, but that's the job. And it's a very difficult business, politics. It is very hard on people and families in particular who get caught up in it and often attacked, and they have nothing really that they can do.
Have you always understood that? I mean, I'm looking back at your relationship with Cameron Slater.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, have you sometimes been the perpetrator of the kind of brutality that you were the victim of in the past few weeks?
Well, I'd also say the fact is that sometimes people don't realise that this is not a game. This is a very serious business. And when we look at things like politics itself, once we start thinking it's a game, people start thinking, well, that's just not what we want to see. They want to see us talking about themselves, which is why in the National Party review, we'll have our review about what's going on, what went on, and also where we could learn. But actually, after that, we need to stop talking about ourselves and we need to get on and talk about the people.
You know what we do in New Zealand when we try not to actually do anything, and that is form a committee. Is the review just that? I mean, you know what went wrong. I mean, you got 26.8% of the vote without specials having been counted. You got 500,000 votes fewer than Labor. You had a stumbling, awful year, really. Bridges, then Muller, then you. I mean, why do you need a review to tell you that?
Well, I think it goes further than that, John. And I think it goes further when we look at the whole issues around, say, Jamie Lee Ross, all that sort of thing. It was actually a very challenging few years. And I think, too, it is important to always have a look, think back, and also understand is that, you know, COVID was also very difficult for us because we weren't the people making decisions about whether there's a lockdown, what we could do, all those things. But it's also about saying to ourselves, you know, that we picked ourselves up and we did the, you know, we did the best we could in the circumstances, but it's always about the people and how they're feeling.
But isn't it about honesty? I want to go back to your maiden speech, and you talked about it's a very Judith Collins maiden speech.
Yes.
And you talked about the poverty confronting the nation, and you ended, this is about the third to last paragraph, and you were really reaching a kind of crescendo of what you stand for, and you talked about poverty. The poverty of which I speak is a poverty of responsibility, a poverty of courage, a poverty of truth. And I wonder, is National displaying that poverty now? Don't you have to steer this feet down and own it and confront it?
Well, that's what the review's all
is
about.
Is it? Or is the review a way of just pushing it off into the margins?
No, it's very much about doing exactly that. Mind you, that was not a bad speech, was it?
It was a good speech.
Not bad
but,
speech.
But the poverty of which you speak, isn't that the poverty National's displaying
well,
now?
Well, I don't think at the moment we're displaying that. I think it is very important for us to go back, have an honest look. But that is something that we will do within the National Party, and it is important for us to do that. Every election we have a review. This is a very deep review looking at exactly what's gone on, but also those very issues that we're talking about. How can we reconnect with voters? How can we better represent voters? And by the way, John, how can we look to the future for voters?
Okay.
I think that's really important.
Look, I've got some footage and you can't see it, but it's you walking out of the first caucus meeting and we talk about reconnecting with voters. So we're just going to play this footage now.
Right.
And I just wonder how a caucus... So there you are. It's fundamentally the same front bench. 7 or 8 of your top 20 voted against marriage equality, for goodness sake, and 2 or 3 of them weren't even in Parliament at the time. This is a deeply conservative, old-school National Party caucus, isn't it? How can you reconnect with New Zealand when you don't even look like a lot of New Zealand?
Well, John, I think that's going to be a challenge for us. And when we talk about, you know, I haven't obviously allocated portfolios or rankings or anything, and none of that's going to happen until we know what the government is doing with theirs. That's really important. But also I'm having meetings with all of the caucus this week individually, so they can tell me what they think they can add value and are they willing to do certain things maybe that they haven't done before. So these are the sorts of discussions that we'll have. But you know, John, it is always a challenge. We've come to that challenge before. We've dealt with it. Yeah. That was worse. That was even worse. And that was one where we came back in 2005. But it is important that we decide, okay, do we want to be there or not? And my belief is we're deciding we want to be there.
I don't want to be brutal, but you got bloodied in 2002, right? I mean, you were just punch drunk afterwards. You came back with a new leader in 2005. Mm. So forgive me, but you know, you roasted. So I want to compare apples with apples. Are you the person to lead National out of this?
Well, I think that I am, actually. And what we need in this at this time, bear in mind, I was only put in place 7 weeks before the first election date, before it got pushed out, and was, you know, I mean, it was the third leader in a matter of months. It is very important that we have stability. But the other thing too, John, is that we need to have that reconnection. We need to be able to do all these things, but we can't do it just criticising ourselves. We need to look forward.
Okay, I want to ask a couple of quick questions. One of them's personal. I'm not sure if I'll get a straight answer from you but it's about you getting the role in the circumstances in which you got it, which was effectively a hospital pass. Mm. And you hadn't got it previously. You hadn't got it after Key left, you hadn't got it after Inglis left, you hadn't got it after Bridges left. Did your caucus, who had been resistant to you as leader before, give you the shittiest break by making you leader at that time? And why did it take them so long? Well, was it the old boys coming to you in their time of need, having looked elsewhere prior to you?
Well, of course, I didn't put my hand up when Simon Bridges left.
No.
I was very clear. I was very happy doing what I was doing, being the MP for Papakura, front bench role, and also thinking about my next book I might write. Mm. So it was a very difficult job that myself and also Jerry Brownlee, given, you know, Jerry came and he took that pass as well.
Do you now resent the fact that you weren't given it earlier?
No, I'm not at all. No, I mean, I think you can see I'm very, very privileged to be in the role, and I am going to make this the you know, my view is to make it the very best, to do the very best that I possibly can. And I just think it's an utter privilege. Look, John, the caucus has made its decision. I am happy to back the caucus, and I'm very happy to work in the role.
Okay, you raised Jerry Brownlee. He lost Ireland, for goodness sake.
Well, I mean,
And if we're talking about the face of National Party, you know, the National Party as it was, don't you need someone other than Jerry Brownlee as your deputy leader?
Well, these are issues that, I want to number one say, Jerry Brownlee stood and took the pass as well, but also took up that role as campaign chair. And he has done a tremendous job over the years, and just taking that role was, you know, is a big. He took it when Todd Muller was actually the leader. Mm. So these are issues that if Jerry wants to be in that role, I will always back him on this.
So because if he wants it, you'll keep him on.
Absolutely.
Do you want him to want is it time for him to stand aside?
These are discussions that still need to be had, but I will back Jerry in that role. And the reason for that, John, is because we need people who will stand and be there and part of the team when things are tough.
Okay, one final question, and it's way too early to say this, but are you going to say to ACT in Epsom in 3 years' time, bugger you for a sweetheart deal? You can win that seat on your own terms.
Well, that's a matter that the board will discuss, and I will be part of that discussion. I think we have to look at that, always look at that afresh, and nobody should take anything for granted.
No. Judith Collins, thank you so much for joining us this morning. We really appreciate you coming in.
Thank you.
Judith Collins, National Party leader.